Many students and faculty are having a hard time adjusting their schedules.
I would tell them to just sit down and like write out their schedule so that they can have time to do what they need to do before they have to like be walking outside by themselves in the dark.
According to health officials, having a predictable sleep pattern or the lack of one affects one's mood.
Everybody has different sort of physical ways of dealing with it. Some people adjust overnight. Some people, it takes a few days. If you're one of those people, you might start a day or two early, kind of trying to get up a little bit earlier or a little bit later, since we did fall back this time, to kind of adjust ahead of time.
Changing clocks from daylight savings time to standard time gave some people an excuse to party for an extra hour.
The hour later was awesome. Like, it made my night so much better. But I know in spring I'm going to be kind of sad, so.
For others, clock shifting is an irrelevant exercise. It simply doesn't matter. For example, Aviation Club President Brian Dirks says any time is a good time to fly.
If you want to fly at night, it could be an advantage because it gets darker earlier. You're not going to have to be out as late.
You can look at the time difference in two ways. Either it can give you a dark, early start in your day or completely throw off your sleep schedule. As for me, it just means I can come out a little earlier and enjoy the cool weather. For Bobcat Update, I'm Natalie Pendergrass.